percussionists that are going to be performing now are largely not percussionists by trade. This is the percussion techniques class. So the students that have to study for music education have to study how to play and teach instruments from all families. And so most of the students here are not percussionists. They are, we're week 10. So you've had 20 classes on percussion so far. So this is their opportunity to play a piece for class. This is the Prelude E minor, and I would like to show cool things about commissioning music is that when you're in an academic situation such as a university, if you're in science, we're doing research, you're doing things to create new scientific discoveries. Well, in the arts, what do? We create new art. And so as much as playing and recognizing the historical music that we play, part of what I think we need to be doing is also creating new music for the future. And this is one of those moments where we had the opportunity to work with Josh, and he commissioned this piece. One of the things that I think is super fun about this piece is that it uses essentially world percussion or ethnic-based instruments in a more concert setting. He uses some Brazilian instruments, we have a Brazilian band here, a Brazilian ensemble. We play samba music, all different kinds of music from Brazil. But in this particular case, he's blended some Latin instruments with some of the African instruments and with some of the Brazilian instruments to create a more concert-style piece, but also using the sounds from those instruments. All right, did I stall enough? Are you guys ready? All right. I see stuff moving less. So I'm gonna take this easy. so that was my fault. But the next piece that we're going to play for you is actually a combination of two pieces, so we need to make a little bit of a shift here. So Postlude number 8 is a piece that is written by contemporary composer Elliot Cole, and it features some very unique writing, and it uses bowed vibraphones. So we have the bows that they will pull on the bars. So just like a violin or any other string instrument, it creates a true sustain as opposed to just a rearticulation of the notes. That will follow right into a second piece called Twilight Without Pause. So these two pieces are, I like to call these our moody mix. They're very sort of spacey and just kind of a neat squeaky stamp music. But anyway, they're very interesting textures, and I think it's just a nice middle portion of our program. So without further ado, we'll start with Postludes number 8 and Twilight.
Thank you.
this next piece, Liftoff, is a very interesting composition that was composed for the Cincinnati Percussion Group. And actually, my colleague, who you'll meet shortly when he brings up the steel band, he studied with the group that actually this piece was written for, Andy. So you'll see him in a minute. But this piece was written for a variety of instruments, but toms, bass drums, and whatnot. But our students wanted to use our collection of Chinese drums for this. I think it's a really neat addition. So this, although the instrumentation that you're hearing right now is not the original for the score, but what this piece does is we wanted to kind of split this up because you'll hear some of this sort of circular playing where some ideas are passed from set to set. And so I hope you will be able to follow that this evening. And it is a liftoff. It's very, it's like a little bit of an explosion. So if you're at all sensitive, you might want to get ready for you to cover your ears because it might have some moments of definite ruckus. So without further ado, liftoff. So I'd like to introduce Dr. Thiroff, my colleague here at Pittstown, and he's this semester been teaching some of our electronic music classes and also working with our steel band. So please welcome Dr. Thiroff and the KU Steel Ensemble.
So it'll take us just a couple minutes to get set up for steel band over here. So I grab some stands. So we've had a very eclectic night tonight, lots of different kinds of music, from transcriptions on a marimba to some contemporary, very drummy types of pieces. And now we're heading to steel drums. Steel drums had their start in Trinidad and Tobago after World War II. America left lots of oil drums down there post World War II, and so they were transformed into instruments. There's a lot more to the history that I'm not going to get into at the moment, but if you're curious, it's all available online. But anyway, so the steel drums here are actually made from oil drums, and as you can see, it's a whole orchestra. So we have hired hands up front, and as you go further back in the orchestra, the skirts on the pans get longer. The notes get larger and lower. I think we're just about there. Thank you.
seriously, what could warm a day up any better? Thank you all so much for coming out. KU Percussion and the percussion class, hang back for a few minutes. We got to move some stuff because there's no percussion concert done without moving. So sorry. But anyway, thank you all so much for coming out tonight. Keep an eye on the website if you want to join us again. Hopefully the next time you come to one of our concerts, it'll be in our new building.